Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss nuclear fission, nuclear fusion and chain reaction. So at the outset, let us begin with few basics. So whenever we see something like this, what does this mean is X is the atomic symbol, that is an abbreviation used to represent the element. A is mass number, that is the total number of protons and neutrons the nucleus is having is mass number, and Z is atomic number, that is the number of protons present in the nucleus is expressed by this number Z. So if we have something like this, then what does this mean is it is a uranium atom having 92 protons and number of protons plus neutrons is 235. So take a piece of paper and write down what information you will get if something like this is present. So as you might have correctly written, it is a helium atom having two protons and two neutrons. Therefore, the atomic number is 2 and mass number is 4. So, we know protons are positively charged particles, neutrons are chargeless particles, and these protons and neutrons, they are present in the nucleus, while the electrons, negatively charged particles, they revolve in the outer orbit. The mass at the atomic scales are expressed in the unit AMU, that is atomic mass unit, and the energies are expressed in electron volt. So let us start with nuclear fission. So what is a nuclear fission reaction? So nuclear fission is a process in which the nucleus of a unstable element having high atomic number splits into smaller nuclei after capturing a neutron. So what do we mean by unstable? The unstable element means having too many or too few neutrons, or the number of protons in the nucleus is more than 83, or it does not have enough binding energy. So if all these things are going to happen, then what is going to happen is the nucleus is going to, if it absorbs a neutron, then it will split into smaller, lighter, more stable nuclei. And this fission reaction is going to produce a large amount of energy. So to give you an idea that how much energy will be produced, a nuclear fission of 6 grams of fissionable uranium will produce the amount of energy equivalent to that generated by a ton of coal or 120 gallons of oils or 17,000 cubic feet of natural gas. So we will go in the further details and I will give you a pictorial presentation of this nuclear fission reaction. So this is a neutron, let us say, and this neutron is absorbed by a heavy nucleus, that is uranium 235. Then this heavy unstable nucleus, when absorbs a neutron, if the energy, kinetic energy of the neutron is nearly equal to the excitation energy of this nucleus in which it is absorbed, then it is going to generate a super unstable excited nuclei, that is uranium 236. So you can see the atomic mass is changed from 235 to 236 after absorbing the neutrons, and the atomic number has remained same. So this uranium 236 is heavy, it is super unstable, and it is excited because the energy, kinetic energy of the neutron was equal to the excitation energy of the uranium nucleus, and then it is going to split into smaller stable fragments, that is in this case it is barium and krypton having atomic number 139, atomic mass 139 and atomic number 56, and krypton with atomic mass 94 and atomic number 36. And few more neutrons are also generated. In this case, there are 3 neutrons generated shown, and the energy generated is 170 MeV. So this lighter and stable nuclei are produced from the unstable, super unstable excited nuclei. So what is happening here is, it is a competition, we can say, between two forces. One is nuclear force and the other is Coulomb force. So this nuclear force is an attractive force and it is a strong force, but it operates in a short range. While this Coulomb force, it is repulsive force, it is a electromagnetic force and it operates in a long range. So when this nuclear force is strong enough, then it kept the nucleus together. And when this Coulomb force started dominating the nuclear force, then the nucleus become unstable and it tried to become stable by splitting into smaller fragments. So here I tried to put two more reactions. So you can see this uranium, it has absorbed a neutron and it has splitted into some other elements, that is xenon and strontium, plus 2 neutrons it has generated and 180 MeV of energy. So there is something missing here and here, and we will see what it is. And the other reaction I have shown is uranium-235, it has absorbed a neutron, undergone fission and produced barium and krypton, plus 2 neutrons it has generated with 200 MeV of energy. So what is missing number is 139. So we need to, so as to let you understand, 235 plus 1 is 236, so 139 plus 95 plus 2 neutrons, that is total is 236. And then therefore, what should appear here? Yes, 38 should appear here. And similarly, in this case, here it should appear 56, while here in the mass number of krypton, it should appear 90. So what is a chain reaction? So chain reaction is a process in which neutrons released in fission produces additional fission in at least one further nucleus. So in this process, the neutrons generated in the first fission are causing more fissions and few more neutrons will be generated, and these newly generated neutrons will again cause fission into new uranium atoms and the process will repeat itself. So in this picture, this is a neutron that is absorbed by this uranium atom and it has generated, of course, the stable nuclei are produced, but other than that, 3 neutrons are generated. So these 3 neutrons, if they find the unstable nuclei, then what is going to happen is they are going to produce few more neutrons. So you can see in the first stage, when it was only 3 neutrons generated, now there are 9 neutrons at the end of second stage. So if we do not control this number of neutrons generated, then all the uranium fuel available will undergo fission at a very fast rate and the reaction will result into a burst of energy, and as it happens in a nuclear weapon. But we can control this reaction where, as it happens in nuclear power plant, wherein the number of neutrons are absorbed by neutron absorbing materials. So you can see these neutron absorbing materials, they have absorbed the neutrons, and we have number of neutrons in the first stage is 3, and after the neutron absorbing material has absorbed many neutrons, we are having 3 neutrons at the end of second cycle also. So this is how a constant power is generated in a controlled chain reaction in a nuclear power plant. So from where this much of energy is coming? The total raised mass of the fission products is less than the mass of the original fission fuel. This missing mass is known as mass defect. So this mass is converted into energy according to famous mass energy formula, E is equal to mc square. So here it is delta m written, that is a small change in mass of the reactants and the products. So E is the energy expressed in joules, m is the mass difference of fission fuel and products in kilograms, and C is the speed of light in meter per second. So let us recall few units. The 1 joule is 1 watt second, 1 electron volt is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 watt second, and it is expressed, if it is expressed in mega electron volt, it will be 10 to the power minus 13 watt second, and 1 joule is 1 kilogram meter square per second square, and 1 AMU we know it is 1.6606 into 10 to the power minus 27 kilograms. So 1 AMU is equal to 931 MeV. This conversion is a useful conversion to remember because it will help us in solving the problems. So if we put it, these values into the equation, E is equal to mc square, then 1 AMU is 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kilograms into speed of light squared. So we get the answer in the joules, 1.49 into 10 to the power minus 10 joules. So we need the answer in electron volts. So let us divide it by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. So the answer is 931 into 10 to the power 6 electron volt. So what is a nuclear fusion reaction? So nuclear fusion is a reaction where lighter atomic nuclei fuse together to create a larger, more stable nucleus. And in the process, it also releases energy. So where it is happening? It is happening in the star, the sun. It is doing nuclear fusion and producing an enormous amount of energy. So by fusion, what do we mean? Is smaller atomic number nuclei are fusing together to become a heavier, more stable nuclei. The total mass of the product is more than the individual reactant atoms, but the total mass of the reactant is slightly more than the product. So this mass, which is mass defect, is appearing in the terms of huge energy. So what it needs is very high pressure and very high temperature. So what is very high pressure is around 250 billion atmospheric pressures and 100 million Kelvin temperature. So nuclear fusion is also produces a large amount of energy. So how much energy does it produce? To give you an idea, then nuclear fusion of 1 ton of deuterium has the energy equivalent that is generated by approximately 29 billion tons of coal. So this is also going to produce a large amount of energy. The point to remember is the mass of the product nuclei, which is, we call it as heavier, is heavier than the individual reactants, but the total mass of the reactant is slightly more than the product. So in this picture, if you see the hydrogen isotopes, deuterium and tritium, under a high temperature and pressure has fused together to become a more stable, heavier nucleus, that is helium, and it has released one neutron plus 17.5 MeV of energy is also released. So you can see in this reaction that hydrogen isotopes, deuterium and tritium, they have fused to become a helium atom, one neutron is released and 17.5 MeV of energy is released. So this nuclear force will be operating in the range of 10 to the power minus 15 meters. So we need to have that much of pressure and temperature so that the Coulomb force is dominated by the nuclear force, and the range will be in the, when the protons will come in the range of 10 to the power minus 15 meters, then nuclear force will be dominating the Coulomb force. So to give you a comparison of nuclear fission and nuclear fusion, this table is given, that how is the definition, what are the conditions, how much is the energy released, and where it is used, and how much is the energy produced, and where, what are the fuels. So for this presentation, I have collected information and few references are given in this slide.